Psalm 4. Have you ever had trouble sleeping at night? Or, you know, maybe you've been anxious at night or tossing and turning, or your mind is just racing with all sorts of thoughts. This is the psalm for you then. And Psalm 4 is oftentimes known as an evening prayer. And in fact, this past week I was talking with a coworker who is struggling with a lot of anxiety right now, especially at nighttime. They're not sleeping really well. And we actually went to this psalm, and this is the thing that we talked about. And so this provides us a great model and great template, because the psalmist writes this in a time when life is not easy for them. And we're going to see sort of hints at that in the psalm. And yet they show us what we do with that and what we can sort of, how we can pray this prayer or pray this psalm and follow it as a way of finding healing for our own soul, because that's what the word does to us. And so let's take a look at it. It says, "Answer me when I call, O God of my righteousness. You have relieved me in my distress. Be gracious to me and hear my prayer." So first thing is just kind of addressing God. I think some translations will also say, "How long, O Lord?" or this, "Answer me, O God." You know, that's oftentimes found in a lament prayer, a prayer of distress, a prayer of mourning. And so you can see right here, the psalmist is not in a good place. They're crying out. They're asking God to hear them. And right here is the direction, verse 2, where it says, "O sons of men, how long will my honor become a reproach? How long will you love what is worthless and aim at deception?" So there's something about his reputation that's maybe being played against. But whatever it is, I guess maybe the big point is, regardless of whether you're dealing with a physical oppressor or a physical person that is in your life as an adversary, or whether your adversary is just spiritual. Because, I mean, life's a lot like that, right? That oftentimes our adversary is a spiritual adversary. I think right now we could say that the current events going on in the world, that we sort of feel like the thing that's looming out there is sort of an adversary, or the adversary, the enemy, is using it to put fear or anxiety in the hearts of people. And so, that just keep that in mind. We see right here, he says, "But know that the Lord has set apart the godly man for himself. The Lord hears when I call to him." So regardless of what your oppressor or what the opposition is coming from, spiritual or physical, external, whatever it be, I love what the psalmist does here. Is they're essentially speaking to that adversary and saying, "You know this, the Lord has set apart the godly for himself. The Lord hears when I call." And it's important for us at times to shout out into the darkness, shout out at the thing that you're afraid at, with the confidence, not just with this random confidence, but with the confidence of knowing that you are beloved of God and that you are protected by God and that you are in the hands of God, that he's not just far off, but he is guiding your life. And that's exactly what the psalmist is doing, is relying on that and speaking to that fear or speaking to that anxiety or speaking to that enemy and letting it be known that God is watching over them. And so we can sort of remind ourselves of all sorts of scriptures that promise that to us, that God would be that wall of fire, that he would be that fortress or that stronghold. And so we can take that and shout it out at the enemy and remind him of who we are in God. Now the next verse right here, "Tremble and do not sin. Meditate in your heart upon your bed and be still." Two pieces to this. This first piece right here, "Tremble and do not sin." That really reflects, Paul actually quotes this when he says, "Do not be angry. Be angry and do not sin." The Hebrew will let it go either way, but here you see right here, "Tremble and do not sin." Because sometimes you can get in bed and you can start to kind of be dealing with all sorts of things, and it can actually lead you to a place of sin. You can start to kind of maybe question God, or God becomes your adversary, you're mad at that, or maybe whatever that adversary is, you start to have unholy thinking towards that person in a way that is not righteous. And he says, you know, "Meditate in your heart upon your bed and be still." And we talked about in Psalm 1, the power of meditating on the word of God and allowing that to just bring you into the presence of God so that you can lie on your bed and you can be still. All right, verse 5, you see, "Offer the sacrifices of righteousness and trust in the Lord." Same deal. So we're meditating on the word, offering the sacrifices of righteousness. I think of Romans 12:1, where, you know, we offer this spiritual service of worship unto God, the sacrifices of worship. And if you want to fight against any sort of fear or anxiety, move into a place of worship. Be in a place of worship in your prayer. Be in a place of worship in your song. Do it upon your bed as you're meditating, right? You move into a place like that, and it is a weapon against the enemy. Worship is a weapon against the enemy. It's a weapon against your anxiety. It's a weapon against fear. It's a weapon against the things that are not of God and not from God. And so worship is exactly where the psalmist is offering those sacrifices of righteousness and this spiritual service of worship unto God. Many are saying, who will show us any good? And then he says, lift up the light of your countenance upon us, O Lord. And then he says, you have put gladness in my heart more than when their grain and new wine abound. And he's just recounting the goodness of God. And we need to do that every now and then. It's easy to get into a dark place and not look around and say, hasn't the Lord been good? Hasn't he been faithful? Hasn't he in my past and even somewhat in my present? And so I can just take inventory of that. And that just gives us a better perspective of life and of God in our life. Now the final verse here. This is good. This is why this makes us an evening prayer. In peace, I will both lie down and sleep. For you alone, O Lord, make me dwell in safety. And so what the psalmist is saying is, you know, you come to your bed and you come to the evening with all of the thoughts racing and the fear or the anxiety or the trouble in your mind or whatever it be, all of those things piled up in there. And yet you can shout out the enemy and remind them of who God is. You can move into places of worship. You can meditate on the Word of God and on the truth of who God is. And then take inventory of all of the goodness of God around you. And at the end, just like the psalmist here, you've done some of these things, right? This is how you've worked out and exercised the prayer and the worship at the end of your day. And you can take that and you can come into the very final piece. And you can just basically lie down and sleep and rest. Because that's exactly what God wants us to do. Is he wants us to go through the day and at the end of the day to take all of our troubles and our fears or anything that we're dealing with that's just that we're carrying and to lay it before the Lord and walk away. Just walk away for tonight. Now, we could talk about Psalm 5 tomorrow or the next time I do this, because Psalm 5 is a pick it back up and let's pray into it, you know, the kingdom come kind of thing. That's not for tonight. For tonight, lay it all down. Trust that God is God and let God be God. Put it in his hands. Put it in his hands. And rest. Rest. All right? Shalom to you. Because that's what we need. The peace of God in our lives. Amen? All right.